Good morning.
Good morning, Bernard.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
What's happening?
Yamawachi.
Yenya.
Oje ko.
It's the same.
Hold on. I can't say. Oje ko. I don't know the response. Wanyemi, something.
No, Oje mla. Oje mla.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oje ko. What does that mean?
Good morning.
And Oje mla means what? Good morning, brother.
That's the response.
Me for miracle, me for me, I'm your fan. But me to, no view, go close, avo, the view. You are not answering. You are just, you are just looking at me. Just
but I had go close.
No, basically asking, how, like you ask. No, okay, I'm just joking. But essentially, you ask the how are you? How's the family, the kids, the relatives, the people at home.
Okay.
And then you also turn around and ask me, and I also say the same thing.
In Benin, the greeting when people meet each other, they have the common thing they ask in the local language is Abro Perea.
Meaning what?
Like, have you done a bit? Like, it's like saying, what's up? How are you?
What language is that?
That's
Abro Perea. Okay, could you Abro Perea?
Or something like that.
Okay.
Okay, let's start with the Ghanaian Times. But before I give you the headlines, the road, the Wager Road, from the toll booth to town, where the sun from the mountains took part a bit of the road, they've still not cleared that. They've still not cleared that. So, Ghana Highway Authority, please go and clear that so that you ease the traffic in the area. It started on Saturday. Please.
So, it's not as if it's rained now, but it's just dry sand on the road.
Yes.
So, people can move quickly.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Now, the Ghanaian Times front page. I'll start with the good news before I go into the others. Ghana has no cholera case in 3 years.
Wow.
This is what is on the front page of the Ghanaian Times.
Mm.
Tragedy, 6 Galamseyers killed in mine pit at Edum Banso. This is somewhere in the west. One more suspect grabbed in connection with murder of UG law professor. Punish contractors who execute shoddy work. This is PIAC. And VP former President Mahama, others attend slain MP's 1 week observance. Funeral is slated for November 27 to 29.
The Daily Graphic says, Northeast floods, large farmland submerged, 13,469 displaced. Government unveils 2 billion CD credit guarantee scheme for SMEs and fixed security challenges, Asante Hene tells police.
Okay.
Now, the Chronicle, gruesome murder of Infantsman MP. Eyewitnesses identified 2 Hacho Fidelity Bank killers. 70 million Ghana Cedi liquidity support, not with me, at Atuesien. An MPP has lost touch with Ghanaians. This is General Mosquito.
The Daily Guide says, Dr. Anya heads to Ho Teaching Hospital. Ofosu Ampofu tape transcription or transcript in court. More tears for MPP, MP, and there's a picture of Lydia Larson consoling Ophelia Hayford. And Efia Shwaslam's NDC. Another Legon lecturer killer nabbed and 6 die in Galamsey pit.
Okay.
Now, the new weekend crusading guide. We are very impressed with the Akufo-Addo's government. This is according to some chiefs. Pawn master can pay your rent and hospital bills. This is something which is also brewing, which we need to pay attention to. GN savings and loan saga. Court dismisses BOG suit. Adjourns case to October 19. Ganoth Nadmo codes flat prone areas to avert future disaster. And Mampong falls for MPP as VP retreats government's commitment to do more.
Okay.
The Daily Statesman says, no more utility fees for tertiary students. Offensive chiefs give Akufo-Addo's thumbs up. And Nadmo says, Bagri Dam spillage aided recent Accra floods.
Seriously?
Now, the Ghanaian Observer, apologize to Ghanaians, disband your fake news cells and throw factory. Deputy Minister fires Inus Afuseni and the NDC. We are very impressed with the Akufo-Addo's government. This is Offensive Chiefs. First Lady storms La Dade Kotopong. Infantsman NPP backs widow to succeed late Eko. And Free Senior High School, the cornerstone of Ghana's development, Vice President Bawumia.
Okay, the informer says, proliferation of small arms, lack of confidence in security agents is a cause. I will revamp fishing sector, Mahama. Civil society's cry for cash ahead of election 2020 and fight against corruption. Ghana's legal system suspect. That's according to IDEG.
The Finder has a very, very, very interesting story on the front page in the education sector. Government to absorb utility bills for public university students from next academic year.
Okay.
We are very impressed with Akufo-Addo's government. Offensive chiefs murdered Infantsman MP to be buried on November 27. Baptist Convention donates 1,000 wheelchairs to Henry Jabba Foundation and impose anti-dumping duties on aluminium coils, circles originating from China, and state calls second prosecution witness in Ofosuampofo Boahin's trial.
All right, the Herald says identity of 436 illegal guns and ammunition shipper uncovered. GRA admits privatization or privatizing transport unit, but dodges competitive bidding question.
Mm.
Mismanagement hits District Assembly Common Fund. 124.8 million cedis irregular spending captured in audit report, and Akufo-Addo has lost fight against armed robbery. That's John Mahama there.
Now, earlier this week, there were reports of job losses in Ghana's oil sector because of some contracts cancellations and some other issues. But this morning, the custodian says Ghana to earn $1.56 billion from new petroleum hub.
Mm-hmm.
Ofinsu chiefs extol Akufo-Addo's government. Carry cameras to polling centers, slide to NDC faithful.
Mm.
And Atacha says NDC embezzled $114 million in Saglemi housing project.
Okay, the BNFT says MSMEs contribute only 4% to domestic tax revenue.
Mm.
That's that's some findings from the PF. Consult locals in implementation of 1v1d project. Peasant farmers tell government, and Dr. Addison BOG win major awards.
Now, the Daily Post, former President Mahama says Akufo-Addo has lost the fight against armed robbery. He also says that the NDC will streamline the fishing sector to ensure growth. And on the same front page, published names of kingpins behind import of illegal firearms into Ghana, the Small Arms Commission.
Let me take you online. A few more stories. Citynewsroom.com. Tefre Hodo, elected new president of Volta House of Chiefs. Meanwhile, Anglong State Group sues to challenge legitimacy of Togbe Siri III. Other stories, 9 months of free water cost government, 834 million cedis, according to the Sanitation Ministry. Meanwhile, IDEG is worried over lack of funds to adequately monitor elections. If you go to citybusinessnews.com, we need people-centered and sustainable recovery post-COVID, BOG governor. Also, make tax compliance less burdensome, MSMEs, PEF to government. And also, Ghana targets $1.5 billion in export tax from Petroleum Hub Development Corporation. If you go to majoronline.com, I will borrow more money to expand Ghana's economy. This is Akpalu. Also, perpetrators of corruption in my administration will be shot. This is PNC flag bearer. Meanwhile, over $114 million embezzled by NDC in Saglemi housing project, Atachia alleges. And Asamoah Bafoujian allegedly assault tennis opponent. If you go to Star News, widows replacing dead husbands is dangerous, according to Jampo. Meanwhile, Akufo-Addo has delivered. Give him 4 more years. Samira to Krobos. And a Fiam Kwanta dialysis unit shut down over deaths. And Jam Brothers wanted by police for assault. That's also on Star News. GNA leads with Bishops Conference. Let's approach December polls with peace. This is the Catholic Bishops. Also, alleged coup plotters case halted following unavailability of jury members. And Mahama promises to revive abandoned cold store project. Guys, let's get into the details now.
Well, let's start off with the Daily Graphic. And the Northeast floods is heavy on that front page. Mm. They are very troubling pictures. Now, the story written by Samuel Dodu in Nalerugu reads, the torrential rains that devastated parts of the Northeast region recently have subsided, but the humanitarian situation in the area remains dire. Some 13,469 people across the region have lost their houses completely, destroyed by the floods, and are currently putting up in schools, churches, and temporary camps set up by the Northeast Regional Secretariat of NADMO. Now, speaking to the Daily Graphic yesterday, the Northeast Regional Director of NADMO, Mr. John Kweku Al-Hassan, said aside from internally displaced people, 51,736 others were also affected by the floods in other ways. The Northeast Regional NADMO office itself is overstretched and has called for support to contain the situation. And Mr. Al-Hassan, who described the development as, quote, very devastating, end quote, appealed to corporate bodies and individuals to go to the aid of the flood victims to lessen
this
their
This is flight. Serious. So was this not the same place that one of the MCs was going to give money last week when he was almost attacked? So it looks like the problem is much deeper than we're thinking of. Kojo, let's come back to you in the Times.
Well, let me take you to the cholera story, which is on page 11 of the Ghanaian Times. Remember some time ago, there was a cholera outbreak in Accra. And it became very topical for weeks. Now, we are being told that Ghana has not recorded any cholera case in 3 years.
Okay.
And the story says, Ghana for the past 3 years has not recorded an outbreak of cholera. Okay, outbreak, not a case, sorry. And this is due to measures implemented by the government. The Minister of Sanitation and Water Resources has said. She attributed the gains to measures such as sanitation agents sensitizing communities on the need to practice personal hygiene, such as hand washing, and the need to keep the environment clean to avoid any outbreak.
Okay, still on sanitation, 9 months of free water cost 834 million cedis, according to the minister. The Minister of Sanitation and Water Resources, Cecilia Abinader-Pass, says the 9-month coronavirus-induced free water supply to Ghanaians cost the government 834 million cedis. At the initial stage of the coronavirus pandemic, government announced 3 months free water to Ghanaians. It subsequently extended it to the end of the year. Now, speaking at the 2020 Global Hand Washing Day commemorated in Accra, Madam Dapas said the free water policy cost the country close to 834 million cedis at the end of the 9 months ending December 2020. But she says the high cost of the free water cannot be equated to the number of lives saved through effective and proper hand washing with soap and running water during the COVID-19 pandemic. And as we all say, long may it continue. May hand washing not end with the end of COVID, if it's ending anytime soon.
Okay, let's get to page 13 of the Daily Graphic. And these days, security matters are quite prevalent in the news. And so the Asantehene is telling the police to fix security challenges. Now, he's tasked the Ghana police to take steps to resolve some of the security challenges facing the country to restore public confidence in the service. He said Ghana had in recent times recorded some violent crimes, including highway robberies, and made reference to the killing of the Member of Parliament from Fransiman, stressing that some of those acts which remained unresolved had a tendency to reduce public confidence in the service. Now, he said this when the IGP, Mr. James Oponbuenu, paid a courtesy call on him at the Menchia Palace yesterday as part of his working tour of the Ashanti region.
More on security. Eyewitnesses identified two Hatchu Fidelity Bank killers. This is the Chronicle. Now, the story says it is possible that the police will kill two or more birds with one stone, as eyewitnesses of the murder of the Member of Parliament from Fransiman constituency have identified two persons in the video footage of the Fidelity Bank killing of a security guard recently. The two suspects, believed to be in their late teens and of a particular West African lingua, have been found from their hideout and assisting the police. The Chronicle security source, who confirmed the apprehension, is hopeful that this may push the police to make breakthroughs in the numerous unsolved murder cases.
Well, talking about murder cases, a 25-year-old man has been arrested by the police for his alleged involvement in the gruesome murder of Professor Emmanuel Yabene, a senior lecturer at the Faculty of Law at the University of Ghana. Ebenezer Kweisi was arrested from his hideout at Kwamoso near Kofreja in the Eastern Region on Wednesday morning by a team of detectives from the CID of the Ghana Police Service. Ebenezer had been mentioned by key suspect James Nana Womba, currently in custody as an accomplice in the crime. The Director General of the CID of Ghana Police, COP Kenyeboa, confirmed the arrest of the suspect to Daily Guide yesterday, saying, quote, he's currently in police custody assisting with our investigations, end quote.
Okay.
Now, the big story on the front page of the Ghanaian Times, 6 Galamseyers killed in mine pit at Adum Banso. And the story says 6 illegal miners, popularly known as Galamseyers, died instantly on Wednesday afternoon when a mine pit in which they were working collapsed on them at K9 near Adum Banso in the Mpoho district of the Western Region. Two bodies have been retrieved and the police are making efforts to remove the remaining 4 trapped in the pit. The two retrieved bodies, identified as Kwata 35, Emmanuel Kaku 32, have been deposited at the Funko Hospital mortuary for preservation and autopsy.
Okay, back to other stories. Tepre Hodo, elected as new president of Voter House of Chiefs. This is from citynewsroom.com. Togbe Tepre Hodo, the fourth paramount chief of Amfuegan Traditional Area, is the new president of the Volta Regional House of Chiefs. He will be assisted by Togbe Patamia Jekle, the seventh of Bato. The two were elected in the Volta Regional House of Chiefs after a back and forth over the appropriateness of the method used in procuring proxies for chiefs who were not able to attend yesterday's event. Now, the House, however, settled the matter, and then the voting took place. Now, the House also elected 3 other chiefs in addition to the president and his vice to represent the voter region at the National House of Chiefs. They are Togbe Afede of Asogli State, Togbe Gbogbolulu of Vakbo, and Togbe Dagulu Anuma of Aveno. Meanwhile, there is a court case affecting one. Now, a group has sued to challenge the legitimacy of Togbe Siri, the Third, who is the chief of Anglo. Some indigenous of Anglo State have filed a lawsuit challenging the eligibility of the Home Affairs of the Anglo State, Toby Sri the Third, to be chief of Anglo. They are also challenging his eligibility to contest an election to represent the Volta Regional House of Chiefs at the national level. The people who have taken the case are Amega Andrew Achukoko, Amega Albert Kwakukume, and Amega Wisdom Atiasa Kukubo. So that's a story to keep an eye on.
There are some stories from the banking sector, Bernard. But before that, let me give you this thing that the Ganoth Nodmo is doing.
Mm.
So they are coding flood-prone areas.
Mm-hmm. Huh.
Flood-prone areas, Edio, to avert future disasters. Now, what they've done so far is that they've identified places that are likely to flood when it rains.
Mm.
And they've identified safe havens where people could go for emergency assistance.
Okay.
And the Municipal NADMO Director, Mr. Simon Sechim, says that several sensitization programs are being carried out in the various schools, markets, and lorry stations on flood issues. You know, some time ago, the June 3 flooding, when it came, AMA released some
hospitals
could go to.
Yes, I remember Bernard interviewed, was it the mayor at the time?
Yes.
Like that,
so the hotspots and the safe havens, I think we need to identify them properly so that whenever it's raining, people could go.
Let me take you on a quick health story. Star News. Efiang Kwanta dialysis unit shut down over debts. This is a serious story. The dialysis unit at the Efiang Kwanta Regional Hospital in the Western Region has been shut down for almost a month now due to non-payment of consumable supply to the unit. In October last year, the hospital entered an agreement with VAO Engineering Services to supply consumables to its new dialysis unit with a promise to pay after the supply had been made. However, this has not been the case. Investigations conducted by Emmanuel Ohinijan, a journalist with Empire News, suggest that the hospital owes the supply VAO Engineering Services a whopping 150,000 Ghana cedis. The situation worsened the plight of the hospital. The dialysis unit served as a huge relief for people who have been sick. Now, for almost a month, the plight of kidney patients in the Western region have been worsened as they've not been able to travel to the region, or as if they had to travel to Central Region and Greater Accra to get treatment because the Efiang Kwanta unit is now shut. So that's the story there. Now, let me give you another story, which is also very troubling. According to the same website, and this is on other websites as well, the Jan brothers are wanted by police for assault. Now, former Black Stars captain Asamajan and his brother Bafo Jan are wanted by the Ghana police for assaulting Godwin Marty, CEO of WebSoft Solutions. The two were taking part in a tennis training match, which involved the brother of Bafo, Asamajan, the former captain of the Black Stars. A police report cited by Star FM coupled with an audio recording of the incident indicates that Godwin Marty was slapped and hit by Bafo Jan, who was the umpire in the tennis game between Marty and his brother Asamajan, after complaining of unfair calls by the umpire. The complainant said he wanted to quit the game after feeling unfairly treated by the umpire Bafo Jan in the match against his brother. He was allegedly attacked by Bafo and his brother also joining in. A medical report from the 37 Military Hospital has been cited after the matter was reported to the police. He has also been referred to a psychologist. His driver vowed that he won't relent until the law takes its course on the two former Black Stars players. This has generated a lot of comments on social media, with people circulating aspects of the audio around as well.
Okay, so Atuesian is in the news. GN Savings and Loans is also in the news.
Mm.
Atuesian says the 70 million Ghana Cedi liquidity support is not with him.
Mm.
Now, that story is in the Chronicle. It says the founder of now defunct Capital Bank, William Atuesian, has told an Accra High Court that the sum of 70 million Ghana Cedis that was transferred into a car bank account of Kate Korte Papafio, managing director of Rural Cable, is not with him. According to him, there is proof that the Capital Bank, as a corporate institution, voluntarily transferred the money to Mrs. Korte Papafio's car bank account. So this is one story. Now, the other story, the presiding judge at the Human Rights Division Court 2, Giftie J. Addo, yesterday dismissed an application by the Bank of Ghana seeking a stay of execution of the case involving GN Savings and Loans Company Limited and BOG over the revocation of the former's license.
Mm.
However, the presiding judge adjourned the case to Monday, October 19, 2020, to rule on the application of the plaintiff.
Mm.
Now, the application of the plaintiff wants a declaration that the license revocation is invalid because the BOG and the Minister of Finance based their decision to revoke the license of GN Savings and Loans as a specialized deposit-taking entity on woeful inaccuracies.
So those are two stories from the courts on the banking sector, but still in the courts.
Ofosu Ampofu tape transcript in court.
Okay.
Story written by Jibril Abdul Razak. Mm. That's on the front page of the Daily Guide and on page 3 as well. A transcription and translation of the audio recording for which the NDC, the opposition NDC chairman, Samuel Ofosu Ampofu, was hauled before court has been adopted as evidence by an Accra High Court.
Mm.
The tape, which is one of the pieces of evidence the prosecution is relying on, is yet to be presented to the court, but the transcription was yesterday admitted by the court. Isaac Osei, a lecturer at the Ghana Institute of Languages, who did the transcription of the audio tape, tendered it when he appeared before the court as the prosecution's second witness in the trial.
This is a very interesting one. Now, widows replacing dead husbands in politics is dangerous. This is Jampo, Star News runs for Jampo, professor of political science, has expressed reservation over the decision by the widow of the slain infantryman lawmaker to replace him as candidate of the ruling party. According to him, this creeping culture of widows of politicians taking up their roles in politics upon their demise could be dangerous in the future. And then he quotes a few things to make that point.
Government to absorb utility bills for university students. Now, the story says the Minister of Education, Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh, has disclosed that no student in the public university will pay utility bills from next academic year.
Wow.
This is intended to lessen the financial burden on students and increase access to tertiary education in the country.
Wow.
He said the Akufo-Addo-led government was first to produce a tertiary education policy to streamline interventions rolled out in the sector. So this is the story. But the question is it for those who will be living on campus in the university's accommodation, or for everybody who is in the university staying in private places?
That's an interesting question. Let me end with the Atachian story. My Joy Online, over $114 million embezzled by NDC in Saglami Housing Project. This is the allegation from the Minister of Housing. Story says the Housing Minister has revealed that following an audit report submitted by the Ghana Institution of Surveyors on the Saglami Housing Project, it's been revealed that over $114 million has been embezzled by the past administration. According to Honorable Atachia, the CID of the police is interrogating his predecessor and other ministers in the Mahama era for allegedly inflating 1,500 units of Saglami Affordable Housing Project. This is a clear indication that the NDC cannot be trusted with Ghana's housing sector should they be voted back into power. Then, reading from a report signed by the president of GIS, Dr. John Amaglo, he said, it is stated in black and white that the amount paid to the contractor is $179 million. It is stated clearly that the total works on the ground is $64 million. The difference is what gives you the $114 million I'm talking about. Meanwhile, the project is not being used as we speak. We've done a few reports there. People are looking for houses, but that project is still not in use. We'll leave it here. Thank you, Nathan. Thank you, Kojo. Coming up next is the City Business News.
Every street, in every